pleasure to be here. My name is Aline. I'm an investor at Ananda Impact Ventures, so almost right. And we invest in companies that address the pressing social challenges of our time. And what we are interested in is both scalable companies, but also companies that have a positive impact on society. And this kind of impact can be given in different areas. And one of them for sure is the digital health and care sector. And I'm happy to be here today with Marcel, who's the co-founder and managing director of Thalea. Marcel, could you please introduce yourself and tell us what does Thalea do?
Sure, thank you. So Thalea is basically building the operating system for the elderly care market, which, as you might know, is in deep trouble. There's highly inefficient market, and we're trying to tackle this with our operating system, which on the one hand is providing a managed pool of caregivers. So we own our own caregiver network. And the other side, we're building smart software solutions for care agencies. So as you know, the market is huge. It's a 60 billion euro market in Germany, also highly attractive because it's almost entirely publicly funded. But as I said, it's facing huge challenges. So we already have a lack of caregivers in the market, and it's expected that within the next 10, 12 years, one out of three patients will be without care. So we need drastic change now in order to change this. In our opinion, the biggest problem in the market is the high fragmentation. So as you might know, there just in the in-home care market, there are 14,000 agencies that operate, and of course they operate inefficient because caregivers spend a lot of time on the street. We see that they have highly manual overhead processes, and this leads to very inefficient outcomes. So out of this huge budget that goes into the market, only one third is really going into care. The rest is spent on driving time and other unproductive time, and that's what we want to change with our operating system.
So what I liked about your approach is how you actually figured out product market fit, because you took some quite unconventional approach. Can you tell us a bit more how you went along there?
So we started with a 6 months research phase and figured out that at least if you want to transform the market, there's no way you can do this with an app, with an IoT solution, or even with a marketplace. And that's why we really wanted to deep dive into the market to find the solution that has the potential to transform it. And that's why we decided to acquire three care agencies to really understand the business inside out. We operated the business, we went with caregivers on tour to see how the real care delivery looks like, figure out the underlying problems. And what we saw is that not only patients are struggling in this market because of low availability, but also that care agency owners are really struggling. For example, the first agency we took over was from a couple that had managed it for 30 years, but they were just exhausted. They couldn't do it anymore because it was more and more difficult to be profitable, to find new caregivers, even just to replace the ones that were retiring, and to manage all of the overhead processes. So you just have to imagine they never went on holidays together, this couple, for the 30 years that they managed it, because always someone needed to be there. And they're not alone. There are many agency owners that are really struggling, and we really want to help them, because otherwise this market is really at risk. And the other thing, but maybe a bit more popular also in media, is the situation of caregivers, right? We have there are a lot of single moms in difficult life situations, and many of them are just so frustrated they leave. They rather work in the supermarket just because there at least they know when they have to work and when they have a day off. In these small structures that we're seeing in the market, they have to fill in a lot of times for sick colleagues. And they cannot reconcile family and work life. So those problems we're addressing with our solution to really improve the outcomes for all stakeholders.
So I think what you described quite well is the challenge that you're trying to solve. But could you tell me a bit more about the business model? Basically, you have a twofold solution. On the one hand, you have the managed pool of caregivers, and then you also have the software solution. How does the business model work, and how do you want to get the unit economics right where everyone else seems to struggle?
Yeah, right. So what we do is we approach care agencies and we offer them to join our partnership model, which, as you said, is not only software, but also our pool of caregivers. So from day one, we really help them to manage capacity. So they have a lot of sick colleagues all the time, so we're filling in. So as soon as they have a supply gap, they can basically outsource patients to us. And over time, what we're seeing with our partners, since caregivers are retiring or they want to grow, they outsource more and more of their patients to us because they understand that we can manage the supply side much better than they can, because caregivers are happier with us, we can pay more, we can make sure they work whenever they want to do and not the other way around. And this way, we can really improve the outcomes, and we take a revenue share for that. So for all the revenue that we manage for those agencies, we take a revenue share. And what is also important is that the software solution is really at the core of this, because the software solution helps us to really plan and match demand and supply on a daily basis to dramatically improve efficiencies in the market. And also, of course, the software solution is used to automize more and more overhead processes that are currently completely manual in those agencies.
You have quite an interesting investor setup. You have the traditional investors and VCs such as Holzbrink and Cherry invested, but you also have us, an impact investor, on board. From the founder perspective, can you tell me, is there a difference in having impact VCs or traditional VCs on board?
So I think overall there's no big difference, right? You all are looking for big opportunities, attractive unit economics, so pretty similar. I think where you stand out is definitely that you are willing to look into, or also able to look into, longer time periods in terms of the investment period, but also in terms of sector focus, right? I think you started focusing on the whole digital health space before it became a really trending topic, and this is beneficial to us, as you already have a lot of sector experience now. So that, I think, sets you apart.
Then last question from my side. Where do you see Thalea in a year from now? Or let's maybe say in 5 years from now, what do you want to achieve then?
So as I said, we really want to tackle this problem of the undersupply in the market. So our goal is to really increase our relevance in the market. So we're working on that every day, onboarding new care agencies. So we really want to achieve more than 1,000 partners in our network. We want to achieve more than 1 billion in revenue in the network, because this will allow us to really significantly change the unit economics in the market and solve the undersupply. And I think the good news for investors here is that we're not only solving a big problem of society, but we're also really building a huge and profitable company. And I think that also shows that impact investing, as you do, really goes hand in hand with attractive businesses. Yeah. And I think ultimately we continue what we're doing already, really focusing on building great tech for this market, and focusing on enabling local network effects to really transform this market.
Thank you.